everyone, I Hiral Popania. In this video, we will discuss about carbohydrate metabolism. In simple term, we can say the metabolism means chemical reactions, they occur in the living system. Most of the important pathways of the carbohydrate metabolism, that are the glycolysis, TCA cycle, gluconeogenesis and the glucogenesis. In this lecture, we learn about the glycolysis. The glycolysis, that means the glucose, that means sugar, and lysis, that means dissolution or breakdown, that means sugar breakdown. It is occurring almost every living cell. This pathway is also called embedded Meyerhof pathway. The location of this glycolysis pathway, that is the cytosol. Glycolysis, that is defined as the sequence of the reactions that converting the glucose to pyruvate or the lactate with the production of the ATP. So, in the simple term, that is the glycolysis means the series of the reactions that convert the glucose into the pyruvate or the lactate with the ATP. Saline features of the glycolysis. The glycolysis, they take place in the all cells of the body. So, the glycolysis occurs in all part of the body. The enzymes of this pathway, they are the present in the cytosomal fractions of the cells. The glycolysis that occurs in the absence of the oxygen as well as the presence of the oxygen. The absence of the oxygen, that is known as anaerobic glycolysis, and the presence of the oxygen, that is known as the aerobic glycolysis. The lactate, that is the end product of the anaerobic conditions, and in the aerobic condition, pyruvate is formed, which is then oxidized to carbon dioxide and the water molecule. So, lactate, that is the product of anaerobic condition, and the pyruvate, that is the product of aerobic condition of glycolysis. Glycolysis, that is the major pathway for the ATP synthesis in tissues lacking mitochondria. Likewise, erythrocytes, cornea and the lens. So, glycolysis, that is the most important pathway for the ATP synthesis in the tissues where absent the mitochondria. Glycolysis is very essential for the brain, which is dependent on the glucose for the energy. So, in the brain, the glucose, they break down and they give the energy via glycolysis. The glucose in the brain is to undergo the glycolysis before it is oxidized to carbon dioxide and the water molecule. Glycolysis is the central metabolic pathway with many of its intermediates, providing branch point to other pathways. Thus, the intermediates of the glycolysis are useful for the synthesis of amino acids and the fat. So, the intermediates, they are formed in the glycolysis cycle. They are useful in the synthesis of amino acids and the fats. Next, reversible of the glycolysis along with the alternate arrangement, the irreversible step will result in the synthesis of the glucose. The glycolysis, that means glucose to pyruvate or the lactate, where reversible of the glycolysis, that means pyruvate or the lactate, that from the glucose, that is known as the gluconeogenesis. Next, reactions of the glycolysis. The pathway can be divided into the most three distinct phases. First, energy investment phase. Second, splitting phase. And the third one, that is the energy generation phase. In the first phase, the ATP, that is utilized in this phase. So, it is the energy investment phase. And the third phase, the ATP generation phase. So, it is energy generation phase. Let's start with the first energy investment phase. In this first step, That is, the glucose is phosphorylated to glucose 6 phosphate by hexokinase or the glucokinase. Both are the isoenzymes. This is irreversible reaction dependent on the ATP and the magnesium. The enzyme hexokinase is present in the almost all the tissues. It catalyzes the phosphorylation of the various hexoses. It is inhibited by the glucose 6 phosphate. In this step, the glucose is converted into the glucose 6 phosphate in the presence of hexokinase or the glucokinase with the help of ATP to the ADP and the magnesium. ATP converted into the ADP. So, the one ATP that is utilized in this reaction. Next step, glucose 6 phosphate that is undergoes isomerization to give fructose 6 phosphate in the presence of enzyme that is the phosphohexose isomerase and the magnesium. So glucose 6 phosphate that converted into the fructose 6 phosphate in the presence of phosphohexose isomerase. As we know, the glucose and the fructose, they are the isomers. The next step, that is the fructose 6 phosphate, is phosphorylated to fructose 1,6 bisphosphate by phosphofructokinase. This is the irreversible step and regulatory steps in the glycolysis. So fructose 6 phosphate that is converted into the fructose 1,6 bisphosphate in the presence of phosphofructokinase and the 1 ATP required for the step. So ATP that is converted into the ADP and magnesium that is also required for the reactions. The fructose 6 phosphate, the 1 phosphate that is attached to the first number of the carbon, that is the fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. Now, after the energy investment phase, that is the splitting phase, the 6 carbon fructose 1,6 bisphosphate is split to 2,3 carbon compounds, that is the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate by the enzyme that is the aldolase. The full name of that enzyme, that is the fructose 1,6 bisphosphate aldolase. In this reaction, the 6 carbon fructose 1,6 bisphosphate that is converted into the two compounds that contains the 3 carbon. The first compound, that is the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, as we know, it is the triose, that means 3 carbon containing compound, and second one, that is the dihydroxyacetone phosphate, that is also contain the 3 carbon. So it is presence of the enzyme, that is the aldolase enzyme. Next, the enzyme phosphotriose isomerase catalyzes the reversible interconversion of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So, two molecules of the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate are obtained from the one molecule of the glucose. As we know, in the previous reaction, there the fructose 1,6 bisphosphate converted into the two compounds, glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. In this reaction, in the presence of phosphotriose isomerase enzyme, the glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate, they are the interconvertible. So the dihydroxyacetone phosphate, they converted into the glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate. So the net reduction, that is the, we have two molecule of the glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate from the one molecule of the glucose. Next, energy generation phase. In this reaction, the glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme converts glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. This step is important as it is involved in the formation of NADHH and high energy compound 1,3-phosphoglycerate. The iodoacetate and the arsenate inhibit the enzyme glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate dehydrogenase. In the aerobic condition, NADH passes through the electron transport chain and gives the 6-ATP by the oxidative phosphorylation. So, in the energy generation phase, glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme converts the glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate into the 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate and gives the NAD to the NADH. So NADH passes through the electron transport chain by the oxidative phosphorylation, they give the ATP. This step, that is inhibited by the iodoacetate and the arsenate. Next step, the enzyme phosphoglycerate kinase act on the 1-phosphoglycerate, resulting in the synthesis of the ATP and the formation of the 3-phosphoglycerate. This step is the good example of the substrate level phosphorylation, since ATP is synthesized from the substrate without the involvement of the electron transport chain. In this reaction, in the presence of the phosphoglycerate kinase enzyme, the 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, that is converted into the 3-phosphoglycerate. So the 1-phosphate, that is cleaved from the bisphosphoglycerate and attached to the ADP. So ADP, that is converted into the ATP. So the 1-ATP synthesized in the reaction. So it is a good example of the substrate level phosphorylation. The substrate level phosphorylation, that means ATP is synthesized directly from the substrate without the involvement of the electron transport chain, that means oxidative phosphorylation. Next step, 3-phosphoglycerate is converted to the 2-phosphoglycerate by the enzyme, that is the phosphoglycerate mutase. It is only the isomerization reaction. So 3-phosphoglycerate converted into the 2-phosphoglycerate. It is a isomerization reaction. Next, the high energy compound, that is the phosphoenol pyruvate, that is generated in this phase from the 2-phosphoglycerate by the enzyme, that is the enolase enzyme. This enzyme requires the magnesium or the manganese and it is inhibited by the fluoride. For the blood glucose estimation in the laboratory purpose, fluoride is added for the blood to prevent glycolysis by the cell, so blood glucose is correctly estimated. So in this reaction, the phosphoenol pyruvate form the presence of enolase enzyme from the 2-phosphoglycerate. This enzyme requires the magnesium as well as the manganese in the reaction, that is inhibited by the fluoride. In the laboratory, for the glucose estimation for the blood glucose. Blood glucose estimation, the fluoride is added to the blood. So, the prevention of the glycolysis and blood glucose is correctly estimated. Next reaction, the enzyme pyruvate kinase catalyze this reaction and form the pyruvate. In the presence of the pyruvate kinase enzyme, in this reaction 1 ATP formation. This step is also known as substrate level phosphorylation. Phosphoinositol pyruvate converted into the pyruvate in the presence of pyruvate kinase. The ADP that is converted into the ATP. In this step, 1 ATP synthesized. Here is the cycle or the pathway of the glycolysis. First, glucose. Here is the glucose structure. The glucose that is first of all in the presence of the hexokinase or the glucokinase, they converted into the glucose 6-phosphate. Here the from the ATP 1-phosphate that is attached to the 6 number carbon, so it is the glucose 6-phosphate. Now the from the isomerase enzyme, it is converted into the fructose 6-phosphate. Glucose and fructose, they are the isomers. Now fructose 6-phosphate, it is convert to the fructose 1,6-bisphosphate in the presence of phosphofructokinase. In this reaction, the first number of the carbon, they attach the phosphate. The phosphate comes from the ATP. So this is the energy investment phase. Glucose 6-phosphate, fructose 6-phosphate and the fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Now next to the splitting phase, from the fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, the dihydroxyacetone phosphate and the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, they are the form. Fructose 6-phosphate contains the 6 carbon. The 3 carbon of dihydroxyacetone phosphate form and the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate form. Now the from the phosphotriose isomerase, they are convert the dihydroxyacetone phosphate to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So the from one glucose molecule, the 2 glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate molecule form in this reaction. From the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, the 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate form with the presence of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. In this reaction, the NADH that is synthesized. From 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, they are converted into the 3-phosphoglycerate. The first number of the carbon, they are cleaved and attached to the ADP. So ATP generation in this step. Now 3-phosphoglycerate, they converted into the 2-phosphoglycerate. It is only a isomerization step in the presence of phosphoglycerase mutase. Now 2-phosphoglycerate, that is in the presence of enolase, phosphoinol pyruvate enzyme, pyruvate product form. And the pyruvate, in the presence of pyruvate kinase, they gives the enol form of the pyruvate. The enol form, they converted into the pyruvate with the spontaneous, which is keto in form. From the pyruvate, the lactate dehydrogenase enzyme, the lactate will form the anaerobic condition. Up to the pyruvate, the anaerobic aerobic condition, the pyruvate product we can get, and the in anaerobic condition, the lactate end product we get with the presence of NADH converted into the NAD plus, or it is the interconvertible reaction. Now, energy yield from the glycolysis. The energy that is calculation from the glycolysis. So, during the anaerobic condition and during the aerobic condition, we calculate the glycolysis energy. First, during the anaerobic condition, one molecule of the glucose that is converted into the two molecules of the lactate, there is a net yield of the 4 molecule of ATP. 2 ATP molecules that are used in the 1 and the 3 step. So, net yield, that is the 2 ATP. So, during a anaerobic condition, under the 2 molecules of the lactate were formed. So, 4 molecule of the ATP, they are the generated. And the 2 ATP, they are the invested in the first and the third step, energy investment phase. So, 4 minus 2, that gives the 2 ATP. Now, during a aerobic condition, in the presence of the oxidation phase, the 2 NADH molecules that is generated in the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphodehydrogenase enzyme, and that enters into the electron transport chain, it gives the 6 ATP. So, 6 ATP and 4 ATP, they are the generated during the substrate level phosphorylation. So, 6 plus 4 and 2 ATP, they are the utilized in the first and the third step. So, net yield, that is the 8 ATP. Again, the 2 NADH molecules generated in the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphodehydrogenase enzyme and enters into the ETC, electron transport chain. So, each NADH provides 3 ATP. So, 2 NADH gives the 3 into 2, that is the 6 ATP, and 4 ATP from the substrate level phosphorylation. So, 6 plus 4 minus 2. So, net yield of the ATP, that is the 8 ATP. Now, regulation of the glycolysis. Most of the 3 regulatory enzymes, they regulate the glycolysis pathway. Hexokinase or the glucokinase enzyme, then phosphofructokinase, that is the PFK enzyme, and the pyruvate kinase enzyme. These 3 enzymes catalyzing the irreversible reactions regulate the glycolysis pathway. First regulatory enzyme, that is the hexokinase enzyme. Hexokinase is inhibited by the glucose 6-phosphate. The hexokinase enzyme, that convert the glucose into the glucose 6-phosphate. So, glucose 6-phosphate, they inhibit the hexokinase enzyme. This enzyme prevents the accumulation of the glucose 6-phosphate due to the product inhibition. Glucokinase, which is specifically phosphorylated glucose, is an inducible enzyme. The substrate glucose, probably through a involvement of insulin, induce glucokinase. Glucokinase, which is specifically phosphorylated glucose, specifically used for the phosphorylated glucose, and that is inducible enzyme. It is induced by the insulin with the glucose substrate. Phosphofructokinase is the most important regulatory enzyme in the glycolysis. This enzyme catalyzes the rate limiting committed step. So this enzyme, they give the rate of the reactions. The PFK, that means phosphofructokinase, is an allosteric enzyme. So it is regulated by the allosteric effectors. Allosteric enzyme, that means they are inhibited by the various factors and the induced by the various factors. The ATP, citrate, hydrogen ions, that means low pH, they are the most important allosteric inhibitors. Whereas fructose, 2,6-bisphosphate, ADP, AMP and inorganic phosphate, they are the allosteric activators. The activators, that means they activate the phosphofructokinase enzyme, and inhibitors, they inhibit the phosphofructokinase enzyme. The role of the fructose 2,6-bisphosphate in the glycolysis. The fructose 2,6-bisphosphate, they considered to be the most important regulatory factors for the controlling phosphofructokinase and ultimately glycolysis in the liver. Fructose 2,6-bisphosphate is synthesized from the fructose 6-phosphate by the using of the phosphofructokinase enzyme, that is the PFK2. PFK1, that is glycolytic enzyme. Fructose 2,6-bisphosphate is hydrolyzed by the fructose 2,6-bisphosphatase. The function of the synthesis and degradation of the fructose 2,6-bisphosphatase is brought out by the single, which is referred to as the bifunctional enzyme. So fructose 6-phosphate, they are most important regulatory enzyme for the phosphofructokinase enzyme, because the phosphofructokinase enzyme, the regulatory enzyme for the glycolysis for the in the part of the liver. Pyruvate kinase also regulates glycolysis. This enzyme is inhibited by ATP and activated by fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Pyruvate kinase is active A form in the disphosphorylated state and inactive, that is the B form, in the phosphorylated state. Inactivation of the pyruvate kinase by phosphorylation is brought about by cyclic AMP dependent protein kinase. The hormone glucagon inhibits the hepatic glycolysis by this mechanism. The pyruvate kinase that regulate the glycolysis by inhibited by the ATP and the activated by the 1,6-bisphosphate. Pyruvate kinase having a two form, active form and the inactive form. Active form, that is the dephosphorylated form, and the inactive form, that is the phosphorylated form. Here is the in the diagram, they gives the regulation of the pyruvate kinase. The pyruvate kinase A form, that is the active form, the dephosphorylated form, where pyruvate kinase B form, that is the inactive enzyme, their phosphorylated form. So the inactivation of the pyruvate kinase by the phosphorylation, when phosphorylation done, the pyruvate kinase, they inactivate form. So it is dependent on the cyclic AMP, it is dependent on the glucagon hormone. So the hormone glucagon, that is inhibit the glycolysis by this mechanism. So glucagon, they act on the cyclic AMP, and cyclic AMP act on the pyruvate kinase. So pyruvate kinase, they converted into the phosphorylated form, and becomes the inactivate. So they are the inactivate, the glycolysis pathway that is the inhibitor. So in this mechanism, the pyruvate kinase, they are the inhibited in the glycolysis cycle. Thank you.